Welcome to State Engineering Service Examination SSCJ section of Winds of Change. For any problem, you can mail us at windsofchange2020@gmail.com, and to download the study material, you can download the app of Winds of Change from the Google Play Store, and the link of which is being given in the description box. Welcome to second video in the continuation of top 120 questions of IGES 4, 5, 6 and RCC. In this video, we will cover question number 31 to 60. So let's begin. Question number 31. Critical section for shear in case of the flat slabs is at a distance of effective depth of slab from periphery of the column or drop panel, or D by 2 from the periphery of column or capital or drop panel, or at the drop panel of the slab or at the periphery of the column. Just think about it. Where we are having the critical section for shear. Critical section for shear in case of the flat slab. The answer will be option B, that is D by 2 distance from the periphery of the column or capital or drop panel, which is given here. Okay, let's say this is the flat slab, okay, and this is the column or the capital or the drop panel, and from its face at the distance of D by 2, that is this depth by 2 at this distance, this is the critical section for shear. Okay, so memorize it. Next question. The thickness of the base slab of a retaining wall generally provided is 1/2 of the width of the stem at the bottom, 1/3 of the width of the stem at the bottom, 1/4 of the width of the stem at the bottom, or width of the stem at the bottom. Just think about it. Here we are talking about this thickness of the base slab. This is the base slab. And this is the thickness that is represented by TB here. We have to determine what is the value of it in terms of the width of stem of the bottom. Width of stem at the bottom is this one. This is the stem. Okay, this is the width of stem at the bottom that is given by TS. Okay, so the answer will be it is equal to approximately width of the stem at the bottom. Okay, option D will be the correct answer. The thickness of the base slab that is assumed to be little more than the bottom thickness of the stem. Okay, it is approximately more than the width of the stem at the bottom. The minimum thickness of the stem is considered to be 200 mm and base slab to be 300 mm for construction purpose. The preliminary thickness of the base slab is given by TB equal to 0.08 h, but not less than 300 mm, where h is the height of the stem. Okay, next question. The percentage of minimum mild steel reinforcement of the gross section area in a slab is 0.1%, 0.12%, 0.15% or 0.18%. There are two cases, either for the mild steel bar or for the HYST bar. There are different percentages for these two cases. So we have to find out for mild steel bar. Minimum mild steel reinforcement of gross sectional area in slab. That has to be, according to IS 456, it has to be option C, that is 0.15%. Okay, 0.15% of the gross area. For HYST, it is 0.12%, and for mild steel bar, it is 0.15%. Okay, so memorize it. These two values are very important. You can find it out in the video of important IS 456 provision that is uploaded at this channel only, the link of which is being given in the description box, or you can visit to the app of Winds of Change where you can find out all the notes as well as the videos. Next question. If R and T are the rise and tread of the stair spanning horizontally, the steps are supported by a wall on one side and by a stringer beam on the other side. The steps are designed as beam of width R plus T, T minus R, under root R square plus T square, or R minus T. Okay, so here it is being given that R and T are rise and tread of the stair. Okay, and now we have to find out the steps are designed as beam of width. Okay, the width of the beam that has to be, just think about it, it has to be under root R square plus T square, that is option C will be correct. Okay, this is a rise, this is tread. Okay, so this length will be the width of the beam for one step. Okay, so memorize it. Since it is it will be parallel to this one, to the stringer beam. Okay, this is for one beam. Okay, next question. An RCC column is treated as short column if the slenderness ratio is less than 30, 35, 40 or 50. Just think about it. When will be the RCC column will be treated as short column? The answer will be option D, that is 50. After 50, this will be called as long column. Okay, next question. A ribbed slab is provided for. Long slab spans can be constructed by rib slab, or the tensile stress is eliminated in the tension side of the slab, acoustic insulation, or all of the above. Just think about rib slab. Can you form the image of rib slab in your mind? The answer will be all of the above here. These are the rib slab. You can see here, it looks like this. You may have seen it in many of the buildings. Okay, the purpose of it, long slab span that can be constructed because of it. Okay, the tension stress in this, the bottom tensile stress that is eliminated in the tension side of the slab, means that will be reduced a lot, and there is acoustic insulation also, that's why it is being provided many a times in libraries also. And difference between solid slab and ribbed slab is the bottom of it. Okay, in the top these both will look similar to it, but in the bottom you will find the difference. It looks like this, ceiling will look like this. It will provide architectural ease also. And there are other advantages of ribbed or waffle slab. It is also called waffle slab also, and you can read this by pausing this video, or you can download this notes also from the link in the description box. Next question. The thickness of the topping of ribbed slab varies between 3 cm to 5 cm, 5 cm to 8 cm, 8 cm to 10 cm, or 12 to 15 cm. Just think about it. It will be a lower value, as we know that ribbed slab are meant for that. The answer will be option B, that is 5 cm to 8 cm. Okay, this is the topping of the ribbed slab. Okay, so this thickness, this slab thickness will be 5 cm to 8 cm. Okay. Next question. The diameter of the transverse reinforcement of columns should be equal to 1/4 of the diameter of the main steel rod, but not less than 4 mm, 5 mm, 6 mm, or 7 mm. Here we are talking about the transverse reinforcement of columns. Okay, that is the ties or the shear reinforcement. That is 1/4 of the diameter of the main steel rod, but this has to be not less than option C, that is 6 mm. It is being given in the IS456 video. You can watch it from the link in the description box. Next question. The load stress of a section can be reduced by decreasing the lever arm, increasing the total perimeter of bars, replacing the larger bars by greater number of the smaller bars, or replacing smaller bars by greater number of the larger bars. Okay, think about it. Load stress of a section. The load stress that can be reduced by providing larger number of bars replaced by greater number of small bars. Okay, so option C will be the correct answer. We will replace larger bars by greater number of the small bars. Okay, next question. The horizontal portion of a step in a staircase is known as rise, flight, winder, or tread. Very easy question. The horizontal portion is called as option D, that is tread. Okay, horizontal portion, this is called tread. Okay, the horizontal portion of tread that will be extended beyond riser, that is called, that portion, this portion is called the nosing. Okay, this is called nosing, and this is the stringer beam which runs parallel to it, and the vertical portion is called the riser. Okay, memorize this term, it is very important. Next question. An under reinforced section means steel is provided at the underside only, steel provided is insufficient, steel provided on the one face only, or steel will yield first. This is also an easy question. When a section is called under reinforced, when the steel will yield first. Okay, that is option D will be correct. Under reinforced section means the steel will be yielding first, concrete will be yielding next to it. Next question. The Young modulus of the elasticity of steel is 150 किलोमीटर पर एमएम स्क्वायर, 200, 250 और 275 किलोमीटर पर एमएम स्क्वायर. थिंक अबाउट इट, वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. यंग मॉडल्स ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ स्टील इज 200 किलोमीटर पर मीटर स्क्वायर, दैट इज ऑप्शन बी विल बी करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द मैक्सिमम शेयर स्ट्रेस क्यू मैक्स इन अ रेक्टेंगुलर बीम इज 1.2 टाइम्स ऑफ द एवरेज, 1.5 टाइम्स द एवरेज, 1.75 टाइम्स ऑफ द एवरेज और 2 टाइम्स द एवरेज. जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट, वट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू मैक्स इन अ रेक्टेंगुलर बीम विद रेस्पेक्ट टू एवरेज वैल्यू? इट हैज टू बी 1.5 टाइम्स इन केस ऑफ द रेक्टेंगुलर बीम. इट लुक्स लाइक दिस. ओके, द वेरिएशन, दिस इज टी एवरेज एंड दिस इज टी मैक्स विच अकर्स एट द न्यूट्रल एक्सिस. ओके, सो हेयर वी विल सी दैट टाउ मैक्स विल बी गिवन बाई 3/2 टाइम्स ऑफ V by A, which is the tau average. Okay, so it will be 1.5 times the average shear stress. Next question, distribution reinforcement in a simply supported slab is provided to distribute load, temperature stress, shrinkage stress, or all of the above. Just think about it, very easy question. It will be provided to distribute all of these. Okay, that is to distribute load, to distribute temperature stress, to distribute shrinkage stress also. Okay, let's say this is a slab in which main reinforcement is provided along the shortest span, and along the largest span we will provide distribution reinforcement. It looks like this. Okay, this is the sectional view of it, and these are provided to distribute the load as well as to counteract the temperature as well as the shrinkage stress. Okay, next question, if the effective length of a 32 centimeter diameter RCC column is 4.4 meter, its slenderness ratio is 40, 45, 50 or 55. This is an important question, that how to calculate the slenderness ratio. Sometimes we are not able to answer it quickly. The answer will be 55, and how it will be obtained, let's find it out. Slenderness ratio is L effective upon R minimum, where R minimum is the minimum radius of gyration. Okay, since effective length is given here as 4.4 and R minimum can be determined from the formula under root I by A. I is the moment of inertia about neutral axis and A is the area of cross section. So it will be calculated in case of the circular column, that will be, since I for circular section, that has to be pi d raised to power 4 by 64 and area is pi d square by 4. So the value of this under root I by A will be obtained as d by 4, where d will be the diameter. So diameter given here is 32 centimeter, so it will be 320 mm divided by 4, which will be 80 mm. Okay, so least radius of gyration will be 80 mm. So the slenderness ratio will become 4400, that is the length of it in mm, divided by least radius of gyration, that is 80. Answer comes out to be 55, which was given in the option D. Okay, so memorize it. It is important that how to calculate the slenderness ratio. Next question. The system in which the high tensile alloy steel, that is silica manganese steel, are used as pre-stressing tendons is known as Freycinet system, Magnell-Blatten system, CCL standard system or Lee-McCall system. Just think about it. In which one we use high tensile alloy steel bars? When we require high tensile alloy steel bar, in the case in which a bolt kind of arrangement has to be provided, which is provided in case of the Lee-McCall system, that is option D will be correct. Okay, it looks like this, where there is a bearing plate at the end of the beam and this is the threaded bar that will be provided under the spherical bearing nut. Okay, and this is the duct in which it is being placed. This is the section, this is the sectional view of this bearing plate. Okay, so this system is called the Lee-McCall system of pre-stressing. Next question. The angle of repose of a soil is maximum angle which the outer face of the soil mass makes with horizontal, with vertical, with the perpendicular to the inclined plane of the soil, or none of these. So think about it. Angle of repose is the maximum angle that the outer face of the soil mass that will make with the horizontal. That is option A will be the correct answer. This is a very easy question. Next question. For the design of the simply supported T-beams, the ratio of the effective span to the overall depth of the beam is limited to 10, 15, 20 or 25. L effective upon depth of the beam for T-beam. Since it is being talking about simply supported T-beams, so the answer will be option C, that is 20. Okay, this ratio will be 20. In case of the cantilever beam, it has to be 7. Next question. A circular slab subjected to external loading deflects to form a semi-hemisphere, ellipsoid, paraboloid, or none of these. It is also an easy question. If circular slab is subjected to external loading, it will form the shape of a paraboloid. That is option C will be correct. Memorize it. Next question. The weight of the reinforced concrete is generally taken as 2200 kg per m³, 2300 kg per m³, 2400 kg per m³, or 2500 kg per m³. Think about it. The answer will be option D, that is 2500 kg per m³, in case of the reinforced concrete section. Okay, and if it is not reinforced, if it is plain concrete, then the weight can be taken as 2400 kg per m³. Okay, so memorize these. It is also important. Next question. The section of a reinforced beam where most distant concrete fiber in compression and tension in steel attains permissible stress simultaneously, that is called balanced section, economic section, critical section, or all of the above. Here, the condition that is being given here, that the most distant fiber in compression as well as the tension in steel that will attain the permissible stress simultaneously together. Usually we call it balanced section. Sometimes it is also called economic section as well as the critical section. Okay, so all of the above will be the correct statement here. Okay, usually we call it by balanced section. There are three types of section: under reinforced, balanced, and over reinforced. So it is normally it is called balanced section. Next question. The diameter of the ties in a column should be more than or equal to 1/4 of the diameter of the main bar, more than or equal to 5 mm, more than 6 mm but less than 1/4 of the diameter of the main bar, or more than 6 mm and also more than 1/4 of the diameter of the main bar. What will be the correct answer? From IS 456, we will obtain that the diameter of the ties in the column should be more than or equal to 6 mm. It is being missing here, that it has to be more than or equal to. 6 mm is also included, which is the minimum diameter that has to be provided for ties. So the diameter of the ties in the column should be more than 6 mm and also more than 1/4 of the diameter of the main bar. Okay, so memorize it. Next question. High strength concrete is used in the pre-stressed member. Why we use the high strength concrete in the pre-stressing member? To overcome the high bearing stress developed at the ends, to overcome bursting stresses at the ends, to provide high bond stresses, or all of the above. Just think about it. Why we provide high strength concrete in case of the pre-stressing member? The answer will be all of these. Why so? Because the high strength concrete that can overcome high bearing stresses that will be developed at the ends. At the ends, there will be high level of the bearing stresses that will be required. Okay. Because pre-stressing load is applied from the ends only. To overcome bursting stresses at the ends, okay, that is also important. And to provide high bond stresses with the steel. Okay, so all of these are important. Next question. Design of RCC cantilever beams is based on the resultant force at fixed end, free end, mid-span, or mid-span and fixed support. Just think about it. In case of design of RCC cantilever beams, the design is based on the resultant force at, very easy question, the force will be minimum at the ends, at the free ends, and maximum value that will be obtained, it will be at the fixed end. So option A will be the correct answer. Okay, let's say this is the cantilever beam. So we will provide this reinforcement, and the design criteria will be based upon the force at this end, at the fixed end. Okay. Next question. The diameter of the longitudinal bar of a column should never be less than 6 mm, 8 mm, 10 mm, or 12 mm. Here we are talking about the longitudinal bar of the column, that is the main bar of the column, that should not be less than option D, that is 12 mm, which is being explained well in the video of important IS 456 provisions, the link of which is given in the description box. Next question. The neutral axis of a T-beam exists within the flange, at the bottom edge of the slab, below the slab, or all of the above. Where the neutral axis in case of the T-beam exists? Just think about it. The answer will be all of the above. There can be all the possibilities. It can lie within the flange. Okay, then it will act as a rectangular beam. It can lie at the bottom edge of the slab. Okay, and it can also lie below the slab in the web section of the T-beam. Okay, so all of these is the possibilities, and based on the different criteria, we will determine the value of the bending moment that can be resisted by this T-beam. Next question. The length of the lap in the tension reinforcement should not be less than the bar diameter into actual tension upon 4 times the permissible average bond stress. If it is more than 18 bar diameter, 24 bar diameter, 30 bar diameter, or 36 bar diameter. Okay, so this is the length of the lap in tension reinforcement that should not be less than, just think about it. The answer will be option C, that is 30 bar diameter. The lap length in the flexural tension that will be given by either development length or 30 times the bar diameter. Okay, whichever is greater, that much will be the lap length that will be provided in case of the tension, flexural tension. While in case of the compression, the lap length has to be reduced. In that case, either LD or 24 times of the diameter that has to be provided, whichever is greater. Okay, so memorize it. It is being given in that video of IS 456 revision. Okay, and this is the clause of IS 456. Which denotes this. Next question. As the percentage of the steel increases, depth of neutral axis decreases, depth of neutral axis increases, lever arm increases or lever arm decreases? Just think about it. If the percentage of steel will increase, then what will happen? Lever arm is not affected much by this. There will be the difference that will be obtained in the depth of neutral axis. So what will happen to it? Since depth of neutral axis is based upon the percentage of steel also, so it will shift to downward, that is the depth of neutral axis will increase. Okay, so option B will be the correct answer. Next question. A rough foundation is provided if its area exceeds the plane area of the building by 10%, 20%, 40% or 50%. Just think about it. When we provide the rough foundation, if the area of the foundation that will be increased by 50% of the plane area of the building, then we will provide the rough foundation. Okay. Next question. The self weight of the footing is not considered for calculating the upward pressure on the footing. Also considered for calculating the upward pressure on the footing. Not considered for calculating the area of the footing, or both B and C. Just think about it. Self weight of footing, will we consider it while calculating the upward pressure on the footing? Just think about it. The answer will be option A, that is self weight of the footing will not be considered for calculating the upward pressure on the footing. We just only take 10% as a safety factor in the load that will be coming from upward, but the self weight of the footing will not be considered. Okay, so option A will be the correct answer. So here we will finish with the 60th question of IS 456 and RCC, and in the next video we will come up with question number 61 to 90. Till that, subscribe this channel and stay updated.